Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, name of God, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, which given us mercy and blessing. And secondly, may salat and salam, always be to our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. My name is Novala Maradilansyah, I'm from STKJ. Today, I want to give you some tutorial about rooting. And the material rooting is static root. And then, let's need to know what is static root. I got from Wikipedia. Static routing is a form of routing that occurs when a router in fact manually configures routing entry, rather than information from dynamic routing traffic. In many cases, static routes are manually configured by a network administrator by adding in entries into a routing table, though this may not always be the case. So, in this practice, I use the packet tracer, and then the name is EVNG. If you have a packet tracer like Cisco, no problem, please use anything. And let's start to our practice. You can open the EVNG, and then you can make the area or topology like this to PC and to router. And if you want to make it, you can add an object and you can add the node, and you can sort like MicroTik, MicroTik Router OS for the PC, virtual PC, and then you can save this, save like this, misal like PC, and then the PC you can save. Nah, this is a new PC, the topology of PC. But we just two router and two PC like that. And then if you have make a topology, you can click MicroTik. Nah, this is a notification of terminal and you can open, but I have open that one. This is router one. Okay, in this topology I call this area is area one, and that area is area two. In area one, I connect the router with ether two to PC and ether three to MicroTik router OS, and then in ether 2 we can add like this. We can open the terminal and we can config. The user is admin and the password is blank. Okay, this key, and then we can add the identify with comment like this. You can make your to your terminal, and this is a router one. Okay, this is a router one, and that's the second is I wanna give name is router two. Like before, the comment is system identify set name and anything name, your name. That's okay, router two. Okay, after this, in router one, you must add the IP address to for your PC, and same like before, same like area one. In the area two, you can add the ether two IP address to for your PC. This is router one. In router one, if you want connect the and you wanna add the IP address, you can add the comment is IP address at address and your address like to 192.168.58 and 1/24, and the interface is Ether2. Okay, you can see at address IP address print with comment print. Okay, we have make IP address for router one, and we can no no we add gateway for the router. This is an Ether2 is IP address for PC, but Ether3 we can add the IP address for the router for the gateway. Okay, like before, the comment is IP address at and the address the gateway we can add the 10.10.1/24. Okay, and the interface is Ether3. We can see at IP address print. Okay, we finished, and in the Router2, this terminal of Router2, like the Router1, we add the IP address. And the IP is 96 and 99, and I mean 99 and 1/24, and the interface is Ether2, and we add to for the gateway for router one in the Ether3. Right. We can add like before, but in the router one, the gateway is 10.10.10 and 1, but in the router 2, we can at the 10.10.10.2/24, and the interface we add the Ether3. Okay, we can see it IP address print. Okay. How to routing? We can add, if you area one, you must add in the IP route in the routing table. The destination is IP PC2, and the PC2, the IP is IP in the Ether2, and then the gateway is Ether3 router 2, like this. This is Ether1. You can IP route S and destination, you can add the IP of network of the router 2. In the router 2, the IP is 96 and 69, and the network is 0/24, and the gateway is gateway router 2 is 10.10.10.2. Just enter. We can IP route print. We can see in here. Okay, this is connect AS. What is AS? AS is commenter or comment active static. But we need to connect the router 2, like the router 1. You can add the root. Because this is the router 2, we must add the destination of router 1, IP router 1, and the gateway is Ether 3 of the MikroTik or router 1. Okay, in the router 1, the IP is 88.1/34, and the gateway is gateway router 1 is 10.10.10.1, and enter. Okay, wait. Sorry. The IP is network of PC1 with 0, and we can enter. Okay, we can check IP root pane. Okay, this is active static, but if we ping, we can check with ping. The IP of router PC1, we can check. This is a work, but if we ping the PC of laptop one, PC1, that's scam, because we not make a DHCP client or DHCP server. And how to make DHCP server in the router one? This is router one. You can add IP and then DHCP server and add, and then sorry, DHCP server is set up and then enter. The interface is Ether2. And then you can enter until DNS. DNS is 88.88. DNS Google, and then you can enter. Okay. And like router 1, the router 2, you can make like that. DHCP, IP, DHCP. Server and set up. You can enter. The interface is Ether2. You can enter, and the DNS is DNS Google. You can enter. Okay. After this, you can open the terminal of PC, and the PC1 you can type DHCP minnet. Okay, this is Dora. Wait, okay. This Dora IP we get is 192 and 168 and 97 and 79 and 254. And then this is IP for router 1. And the router 2, you can add like this, DHCP min server min r. Okay, this is IP for router 2. And then we can check, we can ping, we can check the IP. Okay, we can ping the router too. Okay, that's work. And then we can check in the router too. In the router too, like we can ping the IP router 1, IP PC router 1. That's work. And like that is. Static code. Maybe that's all for me about static code. If I was wrong, you can. I'm sorry. And then maybe that's all for me. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.